Alright guys, I am back. Hopefully you have your candle, you have a mat, and you are ready to join me for this little yoga practice. It's not going to be too long, but I wanted to come on here and come on live. I'm trying to be on Instagram and on YouTube. YouTube, not as successful, but I'll be posting the video there afterwards. And why celebrating winter solstice? Well, it's important to celebrate these different transitional periods in the year because they are energetically very powerful and very symbolic as well. So winter solstice is the longest night of the year, right? It's when dark is obviously prevailing over light, but at the same time, it's when we are going to start to have longer and longer days. So at the same time, light is coming back into our lives. So it's really interesting because symbolically we're looking at our own inner lights, right? Because winter is also, in general, a dark period. It's colder. It's all about turning our focus inwards, calming, relaxing, introspection. It's all about focusing inwards. And so we are going to be doing a practice today that is really looking at those particular things. So how can we calm ourselves, calm our minds, bring more balance into our lives and our bodies, our mind always, and a little bit of self-reflection. We're going to do a practice that takes all of that into account. We'll do a little breathing, pranayama work, and then we are going to finish with a little meditation. All right, so let's get started. If you have your candle, that's going to be step number one. Fire is very much representative of transformation and change. So I like to add this little candle element whenever we're talking about inner work, turning the attention inwards and anything having to do with transformation. Okay, so we're just going to light that right now. We're going to, if it works, right? So let's get another match. My other lighter was not working, so here we are with the matches. So just get yours. If you don't have one, it's not a big deal. Okay, and I'm just going to leave mine in here so it stays nice and secure. And it's going to be accompanying you in the practice, but really we're going to be focusing in on that a little bit more when we do our meditation later on. Okay, so when you're ready, just come to a comfortable seated position. Your back is nice and straight, okay? You are welcome to sit on a support if that feels better. Relax your shoulders. Let the chin come down very slightly towards your chest. And if it's comfortable for you, close your eyes, okay? Just start to notice the breath. Start to notice your body, how you're feeling. Turning that attention inwards. Notice how the breath is moving, okay? What parts of your body are moving with the breath? How is it flowing in and out of your nose? Allow that inhale to fully expand into the chest, so the lung region first, chest, ribs, then it goes down to your belly. And when you exhale, empty the belly first, then empty the chest. Okay, so take your time. See if you can slow down that breath every time a little bit more. Inhaling through the nose. Exhaling through the nose, emptying the belly first, ribs, chest. And just do that two more times. Good. So open up your eyes. What we're going to be doing in this practice tonight is focusing on the breath as a tool for turning our attention to our bodies and turning our attention inwards. It's a real opportunity to slow down the practice and to get you to notice every moment of what you're doing. So what I'm going to invite you to do is make your breath surround your movement. So what does that actually mean? It means that when you inhale, You're going to initiate that inhale before initiating the inhale movement. By the time you finish the inhale movement, you're still inhaling. And then initiate the exhale, and then the exhale movement. And by the time you finish the movement, you're still exhaling. So your breath surrounds the movement. It's actually a lot trickier than it sounds. Okay, so let's start by using a simple movement first. You're gonna have your arms down by your side, and all that we're gonna be doing is inhaling, lifting the arms up, exhaling, bringing the arms down. You have the option to lie down on your back to do this. It's a great way to open the chest and start releasing the shoulders and getting some movement in your body, okay? So let's try it. Close your eyes if it's comfortable. Initiate your inhale, so that's why you have to make it very slow. Start inhaling and then lift your arms to accompany that inhale. You're still inhaling once the arms reach the top. Initiate your exhale. Start moving your arms back down. And you should still be exhaling once the movement is finished. Okay, so let's try that again. Inhale. Initiate the exhale. And let's see if you can do that two more times. All right, how did you do? Harder than it looks, right? So that is the idea. That's what we're gonna be doing for this whole practice. Your breath is gonna be surrounding your movement as we move through and progress here. So the next step is to get some mobilization into your spine. So come to your hands and knees. Your wrists are right under your shoulders. Your knees are right under your hips. Starting with your back nice and long. And start that nice inhale breath and then lengthen the spine. Open the collarbones to the top of your mat. Initiate your exhale first and then round the spine. Move back towards your heels. You're hovering above your heels. You're not sitting on them. Initiate the inhale and then come back, lengthening. And initiate that exhale and then start to round. Go back towards your heels and you're still exhaling when you land at your final position. Good. Now, repeat this at your own pace. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to round and go back towards your heels. Here. some modified sun salutations. And initiate your inhale, then lift the arms slowly. Keep inhaling when you reach the top. Initiate the exhale, bend the knees slightly and forward bend. Inhale first and then lengthen your spine as you continue to inhale. Initiate the exhale and then fold forward again. On the next inhale, we're taking a plank position. If plank is too much, bring your knees down to the mat. Push through the mat, nice strong arms, nice strong shoulder connection. Okay, the first few are modified just to ease into it. We're going to put the knees down, keeping the elbows bending back and close to your body. Lower yourself down to the mat nice and slow. Press the pubic bone down into the mat. Inhale into a slight cobra. Exhale, passing through all fours. Downward dog. You're still exhaling as you reach your position. Okay, so especially with the sun salutations, it's extra challenging to let your breath surround the movement. Especially if you've been used to doing it differently, right? And a little bit quicker. On the next inhale, we start the breath and then bring the left foot forward between the hands. Initiate the exhale and then bring the feet together at the top. Initiate your inhale and then straighten your spine. Come all the way up to standing. Exhale and then start to bring your arms down. Okay, hopefully you're following along well. Let's try that again. Nice and easy. Conscious breath, pay attention, and focus on that breath throughout. Initiate your inhale as the arms come up. Start to exhale, then bend the knees and fold forward. Inhale, then lengthen the spine. Initiate the exhale and fold forward again. Inhale and slowly take your plank position. Tight abdominals, connected shoulders. Start to exhale, then bring the knees down. Continue exhaling as you lower yourself down to the mat. Press the pubic bone down, inhale into a cobra. Exhale, all fours into your downward dog. Breathe, focus. Good. Relax the neck. Next inhale, we step one foot forward between the hands. Start to exhale, then bring the feet together at the top. Inhale, and then open the arms, lengthen the spine, come all the way up to standing. Exhale, lower the arms. Keep focusing on the breath. Do that again. Inhale slowly, then start to lift your arms. Exhale and then fold forward. Initiate your inhale, then lengthen the spine. Exhale and fold forward. Inhale to your plank position. Initiate the exhale, lower the knees slowly, keep exhaling as we lower down onto the belly. Press the pubic bone down, inhale and then come to your cobra. Initiate the exhale, all fours into downward dog. Take a few deep breaths here. Every inhale is an opportunity to expand in your spine. Imagine space opening up between each vertebrae. Initiate your inhale, then step one foot forward between your hands. Exhale, bring the feet together at the top. Initiate your inhale, and then lengthen the spine and come all the way up to standing. Exhale, arms release down. We can intensify it now if it feels good in your body. If you like the version you were doing and that feels better for you, keep doing that same version. Otherwise, we're just going to intensify it a little bit. Inhaling, and we'll slowly lift the arms up and initiate your exhale and then forward bend. Inhaling first, slowly lengthening the spine. Exhale first and then fold forward. Initiate your inhale, then step back into your plank position. Take one more deep breath in. Initiate the exhale and then come into chaturanga. Elbows stay close to the body, lower down towards the mat, and then pressing up into your upward facing dog. A little harder to manage your breath at this one. Initiate the exhale, then connect into your abdominals and press back into your downward dog. Continue your nice, deep, conscious breaths. Good. Inhale and then step one foot forward between the hands. Both feet coming together. Initiate your inhale, lengthen the spine, come up. And exhaling. Slowly releasing the arms. Continue to exhale when your arms are at the bottom. Okay, so just notice when it intensifies, how well are you doing on having the breath surround your movement? Okay, let's do two more like this. So start inhaling, arms slowly come up, initiate your exhale, coming down, forward fold. Initiate the inhale, slowly lengthen the spine. And exhaling, folding forward again. Inhale, stepping back into plank. Strong to go down, chaturanga. Start your inhale, then press up into upward facing dog. Start your exhale, connect and press back into downward dog. One more deep breath in position. And on the next inhale, we're coming back with one foot between the hands. Initiate your exhale, then step the feet together. Initiate your inhale, lengthen and come up. Exhale, and slowly bring the arms down. One more time, here we go. And initiate the inhale, arms reach up. Exhaling, slowly fold forward. Inhaling, lengthen the spine. Exhale. Hold forward. Inhaling, plank position. Initiate the exhale, press down into chaturanga. Initiate your inhale, then up into upward facing dog. Initiate that exhale, slowly pressing back to your downward dog. Beautiful. Good. I hope you're doing well with that breath challenge. Okay, so now let's just wind it down a little bit. We're going to bring your knees down to the mat and then just lower yourself down onto your belly. Your right arm extends out in front and you're going to reach back for your left foot with your left hand. Forehead is down for now. Okay, we're going to really firmly press the hips into the mat. That just helps protect your lower back a little bit more. And on the next inhale, push your foot into your hand, lifting the leg, bring the upper body up a little bit. Exhale and release. And again, inhale and up. And exhale, release. Now try your breath challenge. Initiate that inhale. Then come up. Keep breathing in position. Initiate your exhale. And then exhale more to come down. Initiate your inhale and up and exhale and slowly down. This time you can let your foot go. Switch sides, extend the left arm out, reach back for your right foot with your right hand. Forehead is down. And first few, just do it with the breath, immediately inhaling up. And exhaling down. And again, inhaling up. And exhale down. Now, Let the breath surround your movement. Inhale first. Then come up. Initiate the exhale. And then release. Inhaling. And up. And exhaling. And release. Let go of the leg. As you breathe there for a little bit on your belly, just let that air go down, expand into your lower back. The next challenge is going to be to grab a hold of both feet. If for any reason this is not a good exercise for you or it's difficult for you to do, then just do one leg at a time. That's totally fine as well. Okay? So this time, to add to the challenge, we are going to let the breath surround the movement. Okay? So
forehead is down. Reach back for your feet.
Press the hips into the mat.
Initiate the inhale and then come up.
Initiate your exhale, slowly coming down.
Three more times like that, and I'm going to let you follow your own breathing rhythm. Beautiful. Let the legs go. Rest your forehead on your hands. Just take a moment to notice the work in your body, everything you've done up to this point, the openings, the closings, the inhales, the exhales. Just tune in again. Notice how your breath is feeling. One more breath here. Beautiful. Let's come to your hands and knees. Okay, and let's finish the way we started. Inhaling, lengthening the spine. Exhaling, rounding, going back towards your heels. This is our Chakravakasana. And we're trying to let the breath surround this movement. So it's nice and easy now. Initiating the inhale, then lengthening. Initiating the exhale, then going into your exhale movement. Keep exhaling. Inhale first. Come back, lengthening the spine. And initiating that exhale. Rounding back. Last one here. And exhale. All right, we are going to go back to a comfortable seated position, option to have a meditation cushion. I have a lovely student of mine that just gifted this to me this Christmas. Beautiful, perfect color, and I am going to make good use of it right now. All right, so comfortable seated position. We're going to do a little pranayama work, going into a little bit of a meditation to seal our Winter Solstice 2019 practice. Whatever position you choose, just make sure your spine is nice and long and that you are comfortable to sit there for a little bit. Okay, so we're just going to do a nice balancing breath practice. It's just a beautiful way to balance the nervous system, to bring the attention inwards, to calm everything in the spirit of our calm, balance, and reflection. Okay? So for Nadi Shodhana, anytime we're blocking the nostrils, we're using the right hand to do that. You're using your thumb and your ring finger. Options are to keep the index finger and the middle finger down. It's not always super comfortable for everybody, so some people prefer to put those two fingers in between the eyebrows and then use the thumb and the ring finger that way or like this. So whatever works for you. Okay? Whenever we are blocking nostrils, there isn't anything special going on with the breath, meaning we're not doing the throat breathing, the ujjayi. It's just regular breath, but you
want to slow it down. So think of the whole practice that we've done up to this point and see how slow you can pull that breath in and how slowly you can pull that breath out, okay? So we start by blocking the right nostril and you're going to inhale through the left. Block the left, exhale slowly through the right. Inhale through the same one, through the right. Block that one, and now you keep going. Exhale, inhale, block. Exhale, inhale, block, and so on. So we're gonna do that for a few breaths. So this practice of alternate nostril breathing is just a beautiful way, like I said, to balance the energy. So the yogis believe that we have just two energy lines running through the left and the right nostril, your Ida and Pingala lines, which really represent kind of your sun and your moon energies, or yin and yang, okay? Left being the more calming side, right being the more fiery side. Let's do two more breaths like this. And when you're finished, release your hands down to your legs, to your knees. Take a few breaths in and out through both nostrils. Hopefully you're feeling that calming energy already installing itself in your body, in your system. Let's do our little meditation. So we're just going to do about 3 minutes or so of meditation. And if you have your candle or your representation of your fire nearby, just take it. And so this is my candle, and I'm just going to be setting it here in front of me where I can look at it. Okay. And you just want to look at the flame. So remember that we are using the fire as a symbol of transformation. So what I'd like for you to think about is, first, what needs to be burned? So what patterns, what stories, what is it that is currently not serving you or hasn't served you this year that you want to see burn and go? And then look at the rebirth opportunity of it, and we are going to then think about what we would like to have burn in our soul instead. What is it, the fire that we want to light for this coming year? Yeah, that we're so close to our 2020. What is it that we want to change? What is it that we want to have? Maybe it's a quality, maybe it's a project, maybe it's a new habit, whatever it is. Think about that. So there's the first we're going to do, think about what we're burning, what we're letting go of, and then what are we putting in its place, So I'll just guide you through that.
And then once we have what we want to install into our lives, we will close our eyes and then focus on that for a few breaths, okay? So hands, whatever way is comfortable for you, looking at your flame, okay? Just stare at it. It has quite a meditative power. When you stare at the flame and you're just watching what it's doing, how it's moving, and you're taking in a few deep breaths. What is it that you want to let go of first? And just imagine that it's going into this flame and it's just melting away and disappearing. And in your mind, you can even say, I am letting go of fill in the blank. Think about what you would like to fuel instead. What do you want this fire to fuel inside of your soul for the next year? And then just imagine you're taking that light in your hands, place it where you feel it needs to go in your body. It might be your heart, it might be your solar plexus, it might be the point between your eyebrows, just wherever it needs to go. And now close your eyes, keep your hands there. You will probably still see the flame burning within your mind's eye, and just allow this energy of what you want to grow inside, and just continue deeply breathing in and out through the nose. Let's take two more deep conscious breaths, feeling that fire growing inside, that light growing stronger inside of you. And when you're ready, just open up your eyes. Beautiful. Thank you if you joined me live. Thank you so much for coming on and checking out this session. Otherwise, I'm going to be posting it to my YouTube channel as well, so you have a chance to practice it there. Take time today, tomorrow, to think about what winter solstice means to you. What is it that you want to transform? Also, the importance of slowing down, turning inwards, and how that also serves a purpose in our lives. But most importantly, that this is a chance to start anew. And that life gives us many chances to start over. So thank you so much. Namaste. Wishing you a happy winter solstice, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye-bye.